The countdown is on as we are just 6 months away from the South Carolina primary. And two Democratic presidential candidates returned to Charleston this weekend, hoping to reach voters. Lillian Donahue spoke with those candidates about their push here in the Palmetto State.
Charleston came ready with questions for the South Bend, Indiana Mayor Pete Buttigieg, touching on issues ranging from student loan debt, gun violence, to foreign policy.
That it is worth engaging, worth volunteering, worth voting, worth debating.
Buttigieg spoke with students and community members as a part of the college's Bully Pulpit series, which aims to promote political discussions with young voters. Voters like senior Finnegan Cashel.
But I think a lot of times we don't necessarily like communicate information as well as we could and stuff like that. So I think that being a young voter, it's really important to go to things like this and be informed about what you're saying, the way you're saying it.
We sat down with Buttigieg after the event. He said spending time in South Carolina is critical to moving forward toward the Democratic primary in February.
It's a diverse state. It's a place where you got a lot of Democrats living in a conservative environment. It's the kind of place that reminds me of home in many respects, even though it's unique.
But the mayor wasn't the only presidential hopeful taking on Charleston today. Minnesota Senator Amy Klobuchar spoke with area doctors about the rising cost of health care.
And I think one of the things that we've seen, especially in Charleston, South Carolina, you've got a lot of new businesses and exciting things going on, but at the same time, you have a lot of people that are having a hard time affording things.
South Carolina has been a hot stop for candidates this week, with five presidential hopefuls visiting with voters across the state.
But we're going to have to figure this out or we're going to get left behind.
Despite a competitive Democratic primary, both Klobuchar and Buttigieg say they're not backing down.
I admire a lot of the people running for president, but what I'm bringing is a different sense of urgency, a different approach, and I think a different way to reach out to people who come from more conservative states like I do.
But it is something that when people get to know me, I'm going to get their support. That's what's happened in the past, and that's what's going to happen again.
In Charleston, Lillian Donahue, Live 5 News.
The Republican National Committee reacted to both of the candidates' stops. On Buttigieg's visit, they said his rural plan was focused on expanding government programs, destroying blue-collar jobs, and raising taxes, a plan the committee says was rejected by voters in 2016. On Klobuchar, the group said she supports the same extreme divisive policies as her fellow candidates and that people should watch for what they called her extreme socialist proposals.